Hey guys, this is Fei Wu from Feisworld Media, and in this video, I am going to show you a new tool. I discovered a new app called JQBX, which is Jukebox, that allows you as a dance fitness instructor to create a playlist, connect right to Spotify, and be able to initiate that music and syncing that with all your students. So in this case, you basically work and act as a DJ. So everybody can listen to music at the same time. This will significantly reduce the delay many of you guys are experiencing. What I mean by delay is that you play the music may play ahead of you taking a step, you speak on your mic. So check out this solution. I think it's rather exciting. What I want to do is show you guys and introduce to you JQBX, which is known as Jukebox. It's a really interesting tool, and it has, as you can see, a web app. And if I scroll down, you will see that here it also has mobile apps. Really quite convenient. And what's really dope about this app is it allows you as a fitness or a dance instructor to be a DJ. I mean, what does that mean? That means you can curate a playlist, and you can trigger that playlist to play simultaneously between you and all of your students worldwide. Now, the only prereq here is that all of you guys who are going to be part of this playlist or this form need to have Spotify premium access. So, which means you cannot have a free account. Otherwise, if you have a free account, you will hear ads play at random places so that you as a user won't be able to catch up with the rest of the room. Anyway, I want to show you what it looks like from the web app and how you navigate as an instructor to create your own playlist, how to start a song, how to declare to be a DJ. And you know what? Inside of Jukebox, you can have your students be the DJ as well from time to time. But I guess you wouldn't want that to happen if you want a set format for your class. So the number one benefit of using Jukebox is that now you have officially eliminated that music transferring process from Zoom. In other words, as you're hearing the music is exactly how your student is going to hear it at the exact same time with no delay. So imagine now you're only using Zoom to transfer your video, but not music. Well, now it's actually going to be much easier for everybody else. Your students just have to buy a somewhat decent, you know, regular speaker, Bluetooth speaker to put inside their homes, and they're all set. So let's get started. Jukebox, or JQBX, turns out to be 100% free. They do seek donations, but for you to download and use this, it's completely free with your Spotify premium account. Now, if I log in, it takes a second, and now I basically see a lot of these options that I already see in my Spotify. And what you want to do as an instructor is that you want to create a room. Now, all your profile information such as this are to the right-hand side, and as you can see, you enter your email, you can give yourself a username. I'm going to call myself Feisworld, and you can save it. You can have these email notification settings as well. Now, let's take a look at rooms. When you come back to this main area, you want to select create room. And you can decide whether it's public or private. Now, if you're a fitness instructor, you may want to choose private. And here you can also create a room password. This option in the middle here is optional. You can create genre. So I'm going to say, just call it Zumba. There's some additional settings as well. Here you can set the maximum number of DJs. These advanced options are actually quite important for instructors like yourself. In this case, you can set one maximum DJ. And by the way, that is you. You can also have promotional images and things like that. To get started very quickly, you can pretty much ignore everything else. To make it really easy, you can also check this setting, only allow admin to DJ. So if you are the one creating the room, well, you're the admin. Now what you can do is invite your friends into the room. If you're testing this at home, by the way, it can get a little tricky because you're unable to invite yourself into your room. Or if you share your account with one other person, that person is unable to help you because essentially you're on the same account. Now, in order to create the room, I have to give it a name and also give it a password as well. So this is a test password. So now what you need to do is add your playlist. So right now it says there are no DJ, become one by clicking be a DJ. So if you're the admin, all you have to do is click be a DJ. And going from here, what you can do is find the songs you like, or you know, if you already have a playlist, for example, let's see, I have something called Zumba with Jorge, and here you can select individual songs by clicking this plus sign here, as well as adding all of them to the queue. So if you want to play any of the songs, all you have to do is click play. To know that which songs I have ready to be played, you can just see there's a queue, which is the first tab. So you have this queue. You can also star your songs as well. You can put a star next to the songs you might want to reconsider, or you want to arrange them in a different order and such. You can put them, kind of group them there. Additional features to the right are that people will have the ability to upvote or downvote the song. You can look at the listener list. Right now it's just me, but you can also look at the history of all the songs that you played, and people have the ability to upvote and downvote. Not that this is necessarily critical for fitness instructors. And down here at the bottom of the screen, some of you guys might like it, is people can actually comment on the songs. Again, I know right now everybody's doing fitness classes on Zoom. It surprises me to see the number of chats and comments that are going back and forth while people are working out. But look, we're all in sort of lockdown and corona crisis right now. I can imagine why people want to connect with one another and take breaks from their workout. So something to prepare yourself for. Now, at the bottom of the playlist, you may or may not need these selections as much, such as empty. If you don't like what you have created and queued here, you can just empty the whole thing. You can shuffle play. If you like everything you've set up, you've tried it with a couple of friends, that's, by the way, this really good idea. Before you send this playlist, this whole new method out to 50, 100 of your students, what you want to do is just make sure you test it with a family member or with a friend. And if everything looks good, what you can do is simply share it. And look, to share this list and for other people to join your room, you can share it multiple ways through Facebook, Twitter. You can send a link or email. So for example, this is what an email will look like. It says JQBX invite room. And once people click on this, I'm going to use a Chrome incognito window so you guys can see what it looks like. Now this person comes to the party. You've been invited to join Zumba with Fei. How do you want to be redirected? This person then is able to choose web app if she's already on a computer, or if she gets this message on her mobile phone, then she can choose desktop mobile app. And from here, this person can log in and be dropped right inside of this. So if you're already playing music, the funny thing is then they will come in and listening to the exact music at the exact point that you're listening. And that makes sense because, you know, some people may join your dance class midway as you're already teaching. That person will have your video on her big screen or on her laptop, and the music is already played halfway through. That's perfect. I hope this helps. Please let me know how it works. I saw a lot of enthusiasm from some of the comments as part of the videos I released previously. I was really excited to check this out for the first time. I've never heard of it before, but it looks really promising for people living in areas with lower internet speed, or instructors and students who have constantly experienced delays. This is really going to help them big time. So hope you like this video. In a separate video, I'm going to demonstrate what JQBX will look like on mobile phone. In particular, I have iOS. That's what I'm going to demonstrate with. If you haven't subscribed, now is a great time. Hit the subscribe button. And a lot of you ask how you can best support us. I would say Patreon is the best way, and every little bit helps. Thank you so much. I've included links below on how you can reach us, connect with us, ask us questions, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.